So we are now here at Candolim Beach, Candolim, a beautiful beach with quite a lot of surf. Oh God. Quite a lot of surf, but not too dangerous. Very, very mild pullback in, but it's easy to withstand. And it's a beautiful beach. Take a look down there. Take a look over here, that's hot. Okay. For our two chairs and an umbrella over there, a nice lady gave us a discount to 150 rupees for whatever amount of time. That's it's like $2.50, something like that. It's an incredible beach, very clean. We really like it here. It's our first day here. We were gonna show you on the way in and stuff like that, but we can't. We're doing beach stuff, so there we go. Lots of other Euro tourists here and Indian tourists as well. Generally a little bit more liberal than some of the other places. It looks like it's pretty chill. You can wear a bikini here if you're a person with a body that wants to wear a bikini on it. And compared to Manvi Beach, where an older person sort of gave like some disapproving looks to Natalia for wearing pants over a bikini, where those pants ended up being kind of see-through. Oh geez, waves here. So yeah, just a little bit of a difference there. No diss to Indian people. I know some of y'all are conservative, so it is what it is. But yeah, it's nice to enjoy the feeling of your body free in the water. It's a manageable 30 degrees. It's a hot, drier 30 degrees, but there's a nice breeze. It's very clean. The water's clean. Manvi Beach had a lot of litter on the main part of the beach. Here there's obvious cleanup crews and all sorts of people who seem to care about the beach. But Candolim is a hugely popular beach. Way down there, we've got Anjun and Kalangut and other beaches like that. But they all pretty much look like this. So we'll show you more of the beach walk and the shops and stuff a little later. Oh, it has the best parts of Mexico kind of vibe. I'm having to really concentrate here on not drowning, but yeah, just a really nice spot overall. All the different things you could want to do at a beach. Yeah, we should just kind of show you the chill times here in Goa. We're gonna be mostly in North Goa, so that's kind of considered more like, whoa, the party place. It's a really good time. Long story short, I hope some of this makes decent footage. I don't know, I'm just kind of talking. But honestly, you're gonna love it here in Goa. If you like a nice beach vacation, if you liked Thailand, Mexico, or the beach areas of Vietnam, you're gonna be stoked to. Anyway, we are loving India. This is probably gonna be Natalia's favorite part of the vacation because she is a beach babe, or whatever you wanna call it, a beach bunny, a beach person, a beach lady, a beach human, someone who's enthused by beaches. And she gives it a big thumbs up. Do you give it a thumbs up, Natalia? Oh, that's two submerged thumbs up. So those are good. When she sacrifices her own body to give you a thumbs up from beneath the waves, you know that's good.
Tip to meet local Goans and Indian tourists is to come to the beach around sunset. Here, that hangout period is about 5:30 to 7 p.m. Now let's get an incredible dinner.
We have walked a fair way to come and see this. It's a vegan restaurant in Goa, North Goa to be exact, called Slaughterhouse Vegan. Let's go check it out.
Really awesome sounding menu. Spaghetti amaze balls, pulled pork, two or three types of burger, milkshakes, all sorts of great stuff.
These are the beef croquettes. Let's taste.
That's like a beefy, garlicky, kind of like sausage. Soft, succulent, moist on the inside.
rolled in something delicious on the outside and served with this kind of garlicky tzatziki tasting vibe. Really nice. Trying this papaya milkshake. I am not the one who chose papaya, because generally speaking, weird for a vegan not to like a fruit, but I don't love papaya. But I've been in an ice creamy milky format. It's good. It's leaking down the side, so we just gotta go for it. Here we go. Tastes a lot like papaya. So that's not bad. It's got a little caramel or some brown sugar syrup on the top. Quite nice. And it's fresh, actually. In that format, in this format, I really like the papaya. Creamy, ice creamy, and you can really taste fresh fruit in it, which is nice. It's not like a syrupy papaya or like a papaya flavor. It's papaya. Ready? I don't know how I'm going to take a bite out of this, so please either judge the hell out of me or don't. I don't care. How would you do it? Come on. Looks like we got some rice paper bacon. We got a bean burger in there. We have this beautiful cheesy vibe, some lettuce tomato, and it's full of sauce. Wowzers. And Natalia's burger, which I'll show you in a sec. Nope, she'll show you now. It is awesome. That's some oyster mushroom chicken. And wow, I can't wait to take the first bite out of her burger too. Sauce to it, a hint of sweetness. The crispy battered mushrooms are incredible. Soft and succulent in the middle, and they've been marinated nicely. And there's a couple fighting in the background for this entire meal, so it's been pretty funny. But anyway, the food is impeccable. These burgers are hearty. They're huge, huge, and so reasonably priced as well. Really, really, really tasty. Highly recommend. Natalia, I gotta let you eat. We are here walking the main street in the Candolim Beach area. Lots of stuff to do around here if you like the nightlife and the restaurants, and things stay open till about 11, maybe midnight, some of the stuff. Basically anything you want, you can get. If you like to have alcoholic beverages, I'm not in that club, but if you are, they're reasonably priced here compared to other places where we were at, and they were much more expensive. Beers are about 100 to 150 here for a tall can, if that helps you. And there's lots of liquor stores with spirits and stuff like that. People also honk a lot. That's a thing that happens here. There's a couple of casinos right on this strip within about 5 kilometers that way and another 5 kilometers that way, so lots to do. There's also a number of nightclubs if you want to get down and dance. Looks to me, from what I saw, we're not nightclub folks, but looks to me like about $10 US for a entry fee. What do they call that? Cover. And then, or you can, you know, commit to buying a couple of drinks. Yeah, lots to do on this stretch. They discourage you from swimming or being on the beach after dark because maybe you're gonna get mugged or maybe you're gonna drown. So that's kind of like par for the course when we travel anyway. We try not to be out after dark too much unless it's nice and busy and well lit. And this is definitely the place. So let's show you some of the stuff that you can see in the Candolim Beach area of North Goa. Thank you.
looks like I've seen some decent art as well. I'm not sure how good every single tattoo shop is, but there are literally hundreds of tattoo shops here, so if you wanted to get some ink done, be your own guest. So some tips. If you're exchanging currency in this neighborhood, and actually in most of India, keep these tips in mind. One, carry US bills. This is the one that's changed the most commonly. And carry large denomination bills. If you carry fresh, crisp 100s, you will get 85 rupees to the dollar as of today. If you carry 50s or any smaller amount, you're gonna get as little even as 80 or 82. If they're bent, if they're dog-eared, if they're older looking bills and they're not fresh, crisp notes, the amount you get will go down as well. So keep that in mind. US bills, fresh and crisp, and large denomination bills, 100s ideally. Okay, tips. This commemorates the time that Abbe Faria used the world's first Hadouken and knocked her right onto her ass.
Hadouken!
This commemorates the time that a Abbe Faria, who's blinded by his devotion to his man in the sky, mistook a woman for a piano and tried to play her. This commemorates the time that Abbe Faria left the Catholic religion to teach people how to act like zombies. This commemorates the time that famed marionettist Abbe Faria built a puppet that was just too big to lift with such thin little threads. This commemorates the invention of modern Reiki. This statue commemorates Abbe Faria's first documented proof that his make your boobs get bigger spell definitively worked. Something we've seen in a lot of beach places is the fact that they cater their signage and even a lot of their goods to Russian folks. So if you're a Russian speaking person, you'll be able to read a lot of the signs. If you read English, they're all in English as well. But Russians are renowned for loving a good beach, and so Natalia's been reading me all the signs, which is real nice of her. So keep that in mind. If you want to come and read Russian and see what you can get in Russian, it's all here for you as well. Oh, and the locals speak a lot of Russian to boot. Do you like gummy-tasting things, but hate that they're often made with fish or pork gelatin? Well, Goa's got you covered. All the cashew stores here, which you'll see a ton of, have these amazing special jelly. And they are fruit-flavored jellies that are soft and succulent. Look at this. Look at that. These are very good. I only bought the small container because since I am going to eat 100% of them, I thought I would show some restraint. In that, if I bought a bigger container, I would also eat 100% of them. I really like them. And when you're done having your vivacious, boisterous, loud nightlife, you can retreat. That strip is just over there, but you can retreat to one of these side streets filled with hotels and have a relatively quiet stay. So that's pretty nice, huh? Goa, you're doing a great job.
In the next videos, we meet some truly kind and intelligent people. For Vegan Everywhere, I'm David.